is so fly. was mining, steady bumping and grinding. Nigga, when Third Coast born, that mean we're Texas great. Big face, paper chasing, yeah, we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Eyes are climbing, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding.
I bought a pound from the Latino, the key from nigga Vino. Now the feds after me, cause I brought a bunch of casinos. Dick got number gingos. We did thousands of shows and left with plenty niggas hoes. We rolled bowls down south. So fuck what you talking about. Swangin' 84s, put the gat up in your fucking mouth. Niggas asking me, yo, see where your home. I say, nigga, southeast of the Astro Dome. That's where I roam, cause it's home of the trunk poppin'. So drop the top and get gone. Why the front hoppin'? Ain't no stopping, cause we droppin' like bombs. There it goes, Bunny Rays. Now they know where we from. It's all. Look at the hits we making. Pop wreck, steady shaking, cause the bricks we baking. Niggas far from faking, cause we keeping it real. Stacked up the quarter million, put some rocks up in my grill. And how it feel, that's what them hoes be acting. Some young niggas finally made it, with some slanging and rapping. Commits to strapping, cause it's all for the good. You know they heard us nationwide, flipping bourbons and wood. It's understood, that's why the chart declined. It was me and PAT, steady bumping and grinding. Diamonds shining, hoes be mining. Bumper reclining, bitches hit song like this. It's what we designed.
We Third Coast born, I mean we're Texas raised. Big face, paper chasing, yeah we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Eyes are climbing, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding. Pick up with Third Coast born, I mean we're Texas raised. Big face, paper chasing, yeah, we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Hide the climate, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding. Living lavish is a habit, so I'ma shine up on knees. Baguettes, channel set, move from ounces to keys. Hit the block, it don't stop, roll the 20s for show. Then you know Third Coast about to knock down the door. East and west, they got flex, but the south is on the rise. Red flows, candid dough, screens falling out the sky. Steady bumping and grinding, hoes mining, big face chasing with skill. It's hard to survive. I stack my paper in the land of the trio. How they feel about Texas, I don't give a damn. Scratching pirate, triple bean, trying to get extra gram. Another no slam when I hit the billboard. Like a thief in the night, took over to fly. Shine a new light, south side of in the dough. With the trunk blowing bright, crawling down real slow. Letting you know how we gonna do this thing. Hit the clutch, make our paper gone, let our nuts hang. Piece of chain, peek it rain, leave a stain on the bitch's brain. Let it rain with game, what's my name? F to the T, no other could it be to rock it like me, rolling with that boy C. No quote unquote, ain't no hoe haters get smoked, fucking with Third Coast. Better get ghost, ain't no time to boast. We hold the most, let's have a toast. Now these niggas gonna get roast. Coast to coast, they better know how we gon' do this thing. Step on toes, smash these boys,
down in Texas, man.
We Third Coast born, that mean we're Texas raised. Big face, paper chasing, yeah, we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Eyes to climate, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding. Because we're Third Coast born, I mean we're Texas raised. Big face, paper chasing, yeah, we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Eyes are climbing, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding. Because we're Third Coast born, I mean we're Texas raised. Big face, paper chasing, yeah, we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Eyes are climbing, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding. Because we're Third Coast born, I mean we're Texas raised. Big face, paper chasing, yeah, we gotta stay paid. Living lavish is a habit, so I expose my diamonds. Eyes are climbing, hoes mining, steady bumping and grinding.
Mic for mic check. Yeah, what's happening, y'all? Young Beer Rap Sumo in the building. It is definitely another Monday, and I'm so glad to be here. You know what I'm saying? With the sacrifices of life, I want to thank God for the moment. You know what I'm saying? I want to talk about the city, man, this week, man. Y'all want to talk about the city, man? We had a lot going on in the city. Yeah. Hey, turn down just a little bit, Steve, of the music. Turn down the music down just a little bit. Yeah, there we go, right there. That's cool. Now turn up song. They got to still feel me. Yeah, right there. So what's up, y'all? Everybody tuning in right now, I want to say be blessed, stay blessed. We had a very exciting weekend this weekend, man. You know what I'm saying? I want to start out first saying that I'm proud of everybody in the city on how we trying to come together. You see the app tripping? I can't do nothing about that, bro. Nah, good. But everybody in the city that's coming together right now, I really appreciate y'all. I seen the whole, like north, south, east, and west. What's up, Miss Ash? What's going on with you? I saw them come together for the Texas Wild Wheel Slab Sunday, you know what I'm saying, which was Slab Holiday. Shout out to Vaughn because he officially got the Slab Holiday plaque from the mayor of Houston, Texas, which was pretty cool, man, you know what I'm saying? If y'all didn't know, we had the big three in town this week. That was Ice Cube, you know what I'm saying, three-on-three basketball. It went from 3:30 in the evening to 9 o'clock at night, almost 10. I don't know if y'all had a chance to get to the game, but it definitely was some fun, you know what I'm saying? What's up, Lisa? Lisa? All right. Man, it was just so much happening in Houston. Houston is becoming the mecca again that it's supposed to be, man. We just trying to make sure that the music catches up with the media, you know what I mean? So I want all y'all to be encouraged, man. Just keep dropping them hits. All the youngsters, man, out there that y'all feel like y'all not getting y'all just due, it's on the way, man. It's on the way, I promise you, man. Chucky Tria, keep grinding. God Dog, Al, keep grinding. Fast Lane, keep grinding. J-Dog, keep grinding. Everybody, I'm really feeling it, man. The show is live. You know what I'm saying? I want to talk about politics in the music industry also, man. If y'all would like to call in, the phone number is 832-230-5592. 832-230-5592. And we can definitely get y'all on the air, all right? Man, it's Pat jamming. I know y'all hear that. The sumo to speak up, you know what I mean? So, people with power in the city that can put you on the radio, all right? A lot of y'all been in my inbox, DMing, saying, yo, man, how is it possible that somebody who works at the radio can just throw their record on the radio and get more spins than the average person? What's up, June? June, we're going to get that bang on for you in a minute, man. I got a couple things we need to run through real quick, though. June got a request. Y'all, I got some of y'all from experience, man, from my girl Diamond White, man. It's going down. Hey, Steve-O, turn that a little bit for me, bro. There you go. Yeah. So, we've been talking about politics. We've been having people inboxing me. Like, hey, man, is it fair that a person who works at the station can get their song spent more than the other artists inside the city? You know what I'm saying? I will be honest with you guys, man. I don't think it's fair at all. I believe that everybody should have the same given opportunity when putting in the work and making an excellent record. And if they have a record that is to be played, then they should have the opportunity just to have a chance at the public. Let the public decide and choose what goes on the waves the way they used to. You know what I mean? Because it's just like when you put an album out. Nobody knows what's going to be your single. You can grab a song and, yo, this is going to be my single. But 9 times out of 10, it might not be your single. Why? Because you're the person recording the song, but you're definitely not going to be the one that says, yo, this song is a hit. The public will tell you what your hit is, man. You ever put a CD out? You ever listen to a CD and the single they put on the radio wasn't the best record? I know plenty of people did that. If you have, wave your hands. I'm waving my hand because I know I have. I can name plenty of songs that were people's singles, but once I got the CD, I was like, yo, why did they even just put that? I should have put more than just that on. They should have had this song and that song going. Well, guess what? The industry is about to get back to doing real music, if y'all haven't heard. All right? Every chance you get the chance to put a person album. Right now, Kanye West and his whole camp, they dropping 7-song albums. All right, 7-song albums, and they are selling. How do y'all feel about that? I feel like it's a it's actually a good strategy to sell records and to get attention, because they're gonna, you're gonna want more. Seven songs really is never enough. If y'all think differently, then, you know, call me up, 832-230-5592. Steve, what's your opinion on that?
Hey, what's going on, Sumo? What's up, H-Town? How you feeling, man?
Oh, man. I'm about to end this one, bro. All right.
Okay, can you hear me?
Yeah, I hear you now. What's going on?
What's good? What's good, man? How you doing?
Man, we grooving today, man. You got to get it up, man. Oh, I need man. That energy out of you today, man. We can't be in here quiet and being too cool. I know you got your Rudy V nighttime voice on, but, you know, you're going to have to put some strength behind that today.
All right, we put some H-Town. Stand there up. It is. What's up, man?
Amanda Rose, what's up? How you doing? What? Man, I got some people getting on here that's pretty. Dude Did It, what's up, boy? Murder One, what's happening, man?
Oh, yeah.
I appreciate everybody for tuning in right now. So what we're talking about right now is the industry and politics and just how people are basically taking a lot of this stuff for granted and misusing power and all that. So right. I want people to give me their honest opinions of what they feel is the direction that the city needs to go in. All right, because you got 100 people that's doing music. You got 100 people in the city that claim to be the best. But only a certain amount of people, like a handful, literally maybe five, get a chance to get their music played continuously on the radio.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? So that's the reason why Sumo World has started, because I want to give y'all a chance to get your music played. I want to give you a chance to feel what it's like to have a real interview with somebody who cares about the content in which you're presenting. Because I care about how y'all present the city. Because when I go out the city, I want people to be able to name more artists than just the artists we had that made it major already.
You're right.
I want to be able to go outside the city and a Fastlane name comes up, or A1, you know what I'm saying, or Chucky Trill name comes up. You know what I'm saying? I want a Gwala name, name to come up. I want the names that's in the streets moving to come up. You know what I mean? This is what I need. I need to have it. So I got to be part of the reason why it happens.
Hey, if there's no solution, then you make one.
And that's what hustlers do.
What kind of solutions, if you're an H-Town artist, and yeah, you're really trying to push, you know, your music, your brand, everything, what is the current system that is in place to get your music played?
Be honest with you, Houston has been built off of out the trunk mixtapes, hand in hand selling, hustling, basically since the early 90s.
Okay.
And we still have that same thing going on. But then also, a lot of artists have gotten out of the merch game and need to get back into it, because if you notice, when we go to events, there's not a lot of people still handing out like flash drives and the CDs. Some people don't even press CDs, they just tell you to go online and buy their product. But people are still regular people. And people like to have tangible things in their hand in order to take home with them.
Okay.
You know, like I have the first No Limit record, which was featuring Moby Dick and not Crime Boss, but A Ball and MJG.
Oh, wow.
It had a song called Meal Ticket.
Okay.
Right? And it's when Master P was just the Ice Cream Man.
It's the Ice Cream Man.
Yeah, and I got the album still to this day, because when I saw them, I got the album from them for free. It was a promo thing, and I still have it. Okay. That's how you develop your fans and your fan base and keep people coming back for you, because they have to see these things, and they want to continuously.
People still want tangibility.
They want it. They want it. They want to feel it, man.
They want to
feel it. They want to touch it.
That's true. You know what?
The ladies like, oh, he gonna sing. They wanna feel it. Yes, they want it. Seriously, they do. They do. I know I do. When I go to somebody's concert, I want to grab a hold of a CD, T-shirt, whatever. Even if I can't fit it, I still want it so I can have it to know that I've been there before.
Right.
Man, a reality. Look, I'm gonna get into this Diamond White first of all, man. You know, this song here got remixed by Big Pokey. Hey, I need you to type this in for me, Steve, over there, if you don't mind. Diamond White, he says, so how do a kid from the hood area that's tried to get a job to help budget and invest in their music? What if they can't? There's no such thing as can't, sir. Can't is a bad word. That's like a curse word. I make you go to church for that word can't. We don't believe it can't in sumo world. Type in Diamond White, keep my name out your mouth. We about to get this new joint on from Diamond White. You know what I'm saying? Keep my name out your mouth. I want y'all to feel it. You know what I'm saying? This is one of my homies. She definitely a female MC that's out here rocking and been rocking, and she got a new project on the way. You know what I'm saying? You found it? Yeah. Man, we still jamming this here. You got it? Diamond White. No, that's not it. Keep my name out your mouth. Ella T. Well, anyway, back to y'all, man. What if they can't? Well, listen. First of all, you got to believe in yourself, okay? That's the first thing. Next thing about doing this music game is you got to be willing to sacrifice, all right? So if you can go hang out at something that's happening local, you can carry yourself to any type of event to make money. When I was younger and I wanted to do music, I used to wash cars. I used to rake yards and leaves. I used to help people fix shingles on their house. It wasn't nothing I wouldn't do to be able to go to the studio. So, you know, like, until I bought my own studio. Yeah. You got it? Did you type in Diamond White?
Yeah.
Okay, well, let me pull it up on my phone. On that everyone can see. Man, hold on, y'all. We about to burn this Diamond White real quick.
Well, speaking of which.
Go ahead, brother.
Having basically what you're saying is when you're trying to get your music out there, and you have financial issues and you are not able to afford it, you're saying that use your hustler's mentality.
Yeah, not even just really a hustler mentality. Okay. If you was in survival mode of life, right, and the last thing on earth that you needed to happen was that you needed to be able to be successful in order to live, that's how you have to keep your grind going. You cannot make excuses for the reasons that things are not happening in your life. You really have to take control, and you have to be able to motivate yourself to become the best that you have ever been. And if you don't do that, then, you know, whatever your outcome is what you're accepting. You can't point fingers and blame other people for the reason why you're not successful at something. That's not something you can do.
You're right.
It doesn't work like that. You have to be a winner, and you have to know that you're a winner, and you have to treat yourself like you're a winner. So, you know, like, when I tell people all the time that, hold on, I'm going to run this here real quick.
Go for it.
All right, you can transfer to my phone now. Yeah. About to run this Diamond White. Let's do it.
Diamond White.
I'm the truth. Yeah. Put your stacks on me.
Ladies and gentlemen, Diamond White.
Talk too much.
Here we go. Yeah.
My motherfucking name out your mind. Keep my name out your mind.
Yeah, you love my name. You hang on to that diamond white. You bite as bad as my chain.
Keep my name out your mind.
And put my flow up in it. So they wet shit that you spick it and my swag up in it.
Keep my name out your mind.
You know it just got real. When you signed to a label that offered diamond a deal. Cut me out this game like a knife. You really wish you could kill me, but you ain't about that life.
Keep my name out your mouth.
Chill out, you not hard to find. You still stay at your mama high. She ain't no boss, quit lying. Yo, real recognize real, so the real gon' show D love. Yo, it's the red bottom boss and the baddest chick in the club.
Keep my name out your mouth.
Say, I ain't on that he said, she said. I got a one-track mind and it's on Let's Get This Bread. Broads are fake, I feel like Drake. I hear the lies you poking fun at. Never the flow though. You know I run that.
Keep my name out your mouth. mind.
I hold the track like Pope. Yeah. And when it comes to this rap game, I ball hog like Coke. I'm the truth, and you hate they all rock with the D. And you're like the secret nobody wants, you're like an STD.
Keep my name out your mind.
Before I expose you wrong, you signed to a label, fucking DJs, and you still ain't known.
Keep my name.
Trying to pretend
mind.
Like you don't know that I'm hot. When the dopest DJs co-sign me. What's up, Watts?
Keep my name.
I'm well known and very well protected. So I'm sure you know by now that I ain't the one to be messed with. Don't stop a freak a lot. You make the doubters convinced. I'm so rap a lot down, they think my last name Prince. Switch the house, SUC, FBG. I got all my niggas with me, shout out to SME.
Keep my name out your mind.
We too hot for TV. We all in Vegas doing the most, it's like I'm TMT. Man, I get money all over, watch D shake your state up. I tell a broke bitch quick, ho, get your weight up. You thirsty slut, getting recycled in this industry like cans. Trying to act like you a boss like we don't know.
Bands will make her dance.
You all on my Instagram and Twitter, like I don't know it. Just to watch me, you my biggest fan, you ain't even know it. You wanna be me so bad that you can't even hold it. Remind me of the nigga that hogged the blunt, but he ain't the one that wrote
it.
Even if I'm racked up one deep, man, I don't fear nobody but guns, so I don't lose no sleep. But let me warn you about that. Don't let this cute face fool you, I'm bust a move, not strapped. If you see me, keep it moving like the wheels on a bus. I got a horny 9 miller that's just ready to bust.
My name,
I rock with those who got me. I do my thing like I want, and all this hate can't stop me.
Keep my name,
I really should just slap you for being you. There's only so much disrespect before my people come see you.
My name,
I know them suckers can't stand me. It's all Gucci, they just mad. I got that heat like Miami. I get attention left and right from overseas to Houston. So if it ain't these niggas hounding, it's all these hoes that's choosing. And I ain't never hit a chick, so I let this fine one pass. I pulled a bitch, look like Christina, and my name ain't Jazz.
Keep my name out your mind.
Ain't nobody can stop me. I'd have been gassed up so much, I went from modest to cocky. Just swallow. We know you got a deep though. While I'm pissing on your face, I hope you choke on my ego.
Keep my name out your mind. Mint there.
Yeah, 100, man. We just played that Diamond White. You know what I'm saying? Hope y'all enjoyed that, man. You know what I'm saying? Now we're going to get back to it. Rap Sumo back in the building, baby. We doing this. How y'all feeling out there? If y'all like that Diamond White, I want y'all to call in 832-230-5592 right now. You know what I'm saying? Let me know if y'all like that, man. Yeah, yeah. Man. Anyway, back to it, man. We're going to get back to talking about simple facts and stuff in the industry, man. Our artists said, what time is the show over so I can call in? You call in right now. We live, baby. We live. Call in 832-230-5592. Like we were saying, so if you want to make it in the industry, man, what are the things that you have to do, man? Like, first of all, avoid these DJs that don't want to help. Like, there are DJs out here who have the power to put, just play a song that's jamming, that they know is jamming, that won't play it. So you have to avoid the ones that just want to get in your pockets versus the ones that's trying to help. It's okay to pay a DJ to do your mixtape and to cover some things. I'm not ever going to knock anybody's hustle when it comes to that because work is work. And if a man work, a man deserves to get paid. And that's just true. But at the same time, all the DJs, man, that's out there that's, you know, y'all just basically taking Houston for granted, man. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. It's cool to be cool with everybody who already cool, but man, when are you gonna build somebody else up, man?
Reach back.
They don't like to reach back. They like to reach. They only like to reach forward.
Much less pay it forward.
Yeah. You know what I'm saying? So this game is say what it do. What's up, Scales, man? What's happening with you? So phone number 832-230-5592, man. I see you, man. I see you. So we doing it like that. So we had the big three, right? Which was awesome, man. Had some awesome players in there. I think the coach was Clyde Drexler, man.
Wow.
Who is also a Houston Rockets legend.
Wow.
You know what I'm saying? I know my boy Stack 5 from PA, he was in there playing, showing off that he could still be in the NBA if he really wanted to.
Getting it in, huh?
The retirement really ain't real. He just did that because he just chilling. He out there dunking, acting like he 19 again. Hey, turn out a little bit for me.
Yeah.
All right, yeah, a little bit lower. There you go.
You got it.
Alrighty, man. So, everybody, I want y'all to tell me what's y'all opinion. What do y'all think these artists need to do right now to get themselves up higher? You know what I'm saying? That they're not doing. I want all my scholars, you know what I'm saying? I see who else on here right now. Like Dotrell, anyone y'all want to call in and enlighten me on what y'all feel? Because what I think is that the grind is just not there anymore. I think 90% of people who doing music they just doing it as a hobby. They don't do it because they want to make it out of a situation or because they really want to get to a portion of life where they can be comfortable and open up other businesses. Because a lot of things about music is about the business. All right, people do it because, you know, it makes them happy. That's cool. If it makes you happy, then do it, but don't make it your professional job. Now, when you respect the business side of it, because along with music comes endorsements, can come movies. A lot can come with it, man. I watch people who start out doing music, y'all love Mark Wahlberg, right?
Oh, wow.
They love him, right?
Okay.
Like, he's awesome, right?
Right, right.
But they forget about Marky Mark and the Funky Bunch.
Oh,
did y'all know that that's who that was?
That's right. He was a rapper.
He was a rapper first, and then he turned into an actor. Will Smith.
Rapper.
Fresh Prince of Bel-Air.
Rapper.
He was the Fresh Prince first.
Hell, it was just the show itself was a rap he did.
Yep. And so now he's one of the most nominated actors to ever act on the screen next to Denzel Washington.
Well,
so that's why I tell you that you have to take the entertainment business and as a business, Legal Money LLC, I see you. I need my shirt and my hat, bro. Remember that, man. I need my shirt and my hat. But, yeah, you have to take it as a business because you don't know where it can end up. You know what I'm saying? A lot of artists that, like, you hear about these guys, y'all call them one-hit wonders, right?
Right.
You got artists that done made one song and then they take that millions of dollars they made and build a whole legacy of a different type. Because the business is built for entrepreneurs,
right?
You don't have to rap for 50,000 years in order to get to the money you want to go. Look at Jay-Z; he only makes albums and breakout songs when he wants to, because now he has so many other companies that's building a platform.
When the last time Dre dropped an album?
Listen, that man said it on the line. He say, "What you mean I ain't hot? My last album was The Chronic." Come on, man. Hello, this guy says. What's his name? Jamar Vibe says, man, I love making good music, but I mostly definitely want profit. Yes, everyone wants profit from it, but how do you get your profit is the question.
Right.
Are you looking for profit strictly in shows?
Uh-huh.
Are you a merch head?
Right,
because
right.
If people love you, then they will buy what?
They'll buy your products. They'll buy your service or your product.
Anything with your name on it. Big Sarge tuned in. What's up, Big Sarge? I got to act like him. Ooh, baby. Sumo. There it is. So, he said, I might want to be big time where money always rolling in. When you're big time, money seems to always roll in. But remember, as fast as you get to the top, it's an even faster fall to the bottom.
Man.
If you're not consistent, if you're not persistent on your work, then you definitely cannot get to that point. So LL Cool J, rapper turned actor. Ice-T, rapper turned actor. Tupac, rapper turned actor. Listen, it's a million ways to make money in the industry. And that's a shout-out to my boy Bump over there, man. You know what I'm saying? He just put that juice in the air right there.
Man.
Yeah, shout-out to the Juice King. I know he probably watching, too. You know what I'm saying? Juice up.
Juice.
Yeah, the big juice. He got that naked noodle in the morning. I'm going to get him up here pretty soon.
Oh.
He said his Naked Noodle segment, he gets about 15,000 viewers a morning.
Really?
Yeah, he's pretty dope. Pretty dead in red, man.
Wow. Okay. Money is being made out here, ladies and gentlemen.
Hey, man, listen, man. It's very good to have different entities to make bread from, all right?
Yeah.
Like me, myself, I believe that me being an artist, being a PR, being an actor, being an activist out here and being a lifesaver and a big brother to a lot of people. enables me to be able to make money in a million ways. I never know what's going to hit my phone, okay? And that's the way your life really should be, because if you're doing positive things, you're getting positive feedback. You only grow what you plant.
Hey.
And real men only eat what they kill.
Man, okay.
Yeah.
I hear you. I hear you.
Y'all don't know what that means. A lot of y'all don't know what that means. You only eat what you kill, man. If you grow it and you can eat it, you either grow it or you kill it. You know what I'm saying? So when we out here in this world where we're hustling, we're entrepreneurs, you have to put forth your best efforts. There's no such thing as I can't, I couldn't, I might not, or maybe it won't. Those words don't exist. It's always about finding a way. Because there is always a way to make something positive happen.
You know what? That's a very important point there, because optimism is a lot to do with success.
Yeah.
If you don't even have a vision for where you can possibly go, then why should anybody else want to mess with you? Why would anybody else want to mess with somebody that doesn't believe in themselves in some kind of way?
And you have to invest in yourself first, people. Hey. Please do not be afraid to take your money that you make out your pocket once you're done buying your Jordans, all your little weed, all and everything, and invest it in your business, man.
If you don't invest in yourself, you don't believe in yourself.
That's name of the game, man. Name of the game.
If you don't believe in yourself.
This weekend, right, I'm going to tell you something. Everybody was looking at the cars, right, at the Slab Fest, right? And, you know, people were winning awards for the best music, the best paint job, best interior. But I'm going to tell everybody something. Everybody was kind of funny face when they didn't win, right? But then looking at the guys who did win, that envy is a bad bug. But those guys invested that money into them cars, man.
That was money that was spent.
You know, some of the paint jobs, $10,000. You know what I mean?
The prize money don't even cover that.
No, some of these guys' interior cost more than furniture inside your house.
Whole house. Whole house.
I'm just saying. So when you see him winning, and you're like, man, how is he winning? And he got the Louis Vuitton insides. He got the gator seats. He got the casket tucked with the buttons. Like, Slab Fest is for real. You know, Slab Holiday is for real. So you got to bring out your A game. And I'm only bringing that up to say that those guys believed in themselves.
They invested in themselves.
They spent their money.
Expensive.
And guess what? They got their pride of winning that came from them investing their money.
So when people are investing in everything else but themselves.
Yeah. Well, really, I'm going to tell you something. I think I told one of my friends this. It was like, yo, let's go to McCormick's, you know what I'm saying, to get some food. And I was like, yo, I ain't really feeling that. Like, I don't really spend my money on big money on intake.
Right.
I spend it on I'm not going to spend $100 on a piece of steak. I can't do it. And not slugging you, Steve. I know you're a steakhead. You like to go get the juiciest steak on the market.
But not every day. It's all, you know what I'm saying? That's all about moderation.
Yeah.
So my thing is I might get a $50 steak, but then watch how I save money everywhere else.
Yeah.
You know?
But see, a lot of you guys, they don't do that, man. Hold on. I got somebody preaching. Let me read it.
Go ahead.
All right, so Scales, he said, I pay for my own distribution.
There you go.
He said, I put it into my studio every chance I get. You got to reach out and step out of your comfort zone. Even though I met Young Beer Rap Sumo, I don't blow him up every day trying to get. Hold on, let me read the rest of it, Steve.
Go for it.
I don't roll trying to get on the show. Some artists got the wrong idea. Hey, man, you're absolutely right about that, Scales, man. You're absolutely right. Because the investing portion of what you're doing and showing people makes them want to do business with you. Like, when I see an artist and they're doing things, right, and they're like, yo, I need to come on the show. Yo, I give you a discount because you're already grinding. You're already putting in the work. So why would I try to rip your pockets apart? Now, if you come to me and you just like, yo, I want to get on free. And I'm like, well, you disrespecting me now because I put the work in.
Pay the bills. You being here is not free, bro.
No, we got to pay the bills, man. The bills got to be paid. So when you see me, hey, the lights on, the mic's on. I got on. Hey, man, don't start, man. Don't start. We can talk about this entertainment business all day long. Everything costs money. All right, everything. If you're not gonna invest in it, then you know, don't call the connects that you meet. You know what I'm saying? But like Squirrel right there, he said something real, and I can appreciate that, brother. I appreciate that definitely. Hold on, what did he say? Yesterday I called you and you said you want to talk some real business with me. What's up, young man? Now, I hate doing this on air to people. Do you think I'm gonna talk business to you while I'm on air, brother? Are you serious?
Well, right. Maybe he didn't mean it that way, bro.
Listen, he's not going to get the donkey of the day like
no,
Charlemagne.
No, man, don't do it like that. Don't listen, do it. Don't do it.
But he going to get sumo. Ooh, you boy. Ooh, you boy. Get it right. Hit me after my show, man.
First of all, I want to say to everybody, if you're really interested, if you are really interested in making moves, first of all, get up off of your behind. First.
You got to say a little more energetic. So
I'm sorry.
You're too relaxed.
I was trying to be relaxed about it.
No, don't be relaxed about it. We're talking today, baby.
Hey, yo, listen, H-Town, are you really trying to be about your paper? You really trying to step your game up? Get off of the couch. Get off of the porch.
Put the food down. put the controller down. Put the PlayStation down.
Let me tell you something. When I had no money at all, and I made a decision that I'm going to do whatever is necessary to make things happen.
Yeah.
And I had nothing to my name.
Nothing. Hey, I think nothing is what gives us the juice and the energy to get further in life.
Yeah.
See, me also, I had a point where I hit rock bottom, right?
Yeah.
And when you hit rock bottom, be honest with you, there's no other place to go but up.
Man.
So when you feel like you at the bottom and your life is like blah, 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 right?
Yeah.
And I'm going to just call it that because I don't want to curse because I've been working on the cursing right now. So your life is blah, 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 right? And you're like, man, I don't have this. I don't have that. I can't go here. I can't go there. Then that's when the time you need to get to yourself, grab your Bible, and get you and God and have a deep conversation, and you figure out what it is that you can offer the world that they will pay you to do.
Then do it.
Do it. Nike sign.
Right.
Nike sign, people.
Just do it.
Go, and I ain't talking about the new Nike sign. I ain't talking about the swoosh. I'm talking about the just do it, baby.
Just do it. My thing is when you make a decision, I am going to be successful with whatever I'm doing.
That's right.
Then you start looking at opportunities that while you are sitting on the couch and watching the world go by day after day, watching other people come up.
Yeah.
And you were sitting there watching TV and watching everybody else. Why weren't you watching yourself?
You know the guy I hate the most?
Who's that?
And I ain't gonna say hate because hate is a strong word. But I don't like the fella, right? That sits around and says, I know him, I know him, I know him, and I know him.
Right.
I know him, and I know him, and that's my homie, and I know him. And everybody he pointing at got all the money in the world, right?
Right.
And he's sitting in one place.
Right.
Not even attempting to get to that level.
Right.
That guy, do not be that guy.
Well, he might be a professional fan.
But I'm telling y'all, do not be that guy, man. Get
Don't
off,
be that guy.
Get yourself well, together and know that this, there's only one you in the world, right? And only you are responsible for what happens with you. Nobody else around you, nobody can give you their life. Nobody can give you their hard work and they profit from their hard work. You really have to get it yourself. And it's one you, and God gave you one life, so you better live it to the fullest, man. And
you
take care of your business.
Take care of business.
Yeah.
Do what is necessary to achieve the goals that you want to reach.
Hey, and if you meet somebody and they're in your circle, let's say not meet somebody, but you got people around you, right?
Okay.
And they don't want to encourage you to do the things that you're trying to do, right? And every time you bring it up, man, I'm trying to sew this shirt. You can't sew no shirt. Then those are the people you definitely need to leave alone. You need to get away from them. You need to make your distance. You need to make sure you shake them off like leaves off a tree.
More or less, you need to be around positive people and positive energy.
Yeah.
Those that will keep you going when you feel like quitting. Because if you make the decision to be successful and you come across all kinds of challenges, then you should be around people who are encouraging you to keep going.
And stop being afraid to fail.
Failure is not the opposite of success.
It is
a part of it.
Hey, I met a guy the other night inside of Walmart, right?
Go ahead.
His name is Honor.
Honor.
Honor, what was that statement Honor told me, Steve?
Man.
Honor told me, he said there's a saying where I'm from. And he said that there's no such thing as
it was something about
a quitter?
About taking a step.
Yeah.
And starting.
Yeah. He said that the only way you can never lose is if you never start.
You know what? I think it's the other way around. It's like, it was basically a spin off of you miss 100% of the shots you don't take.
Yeah.
It was more or less saying that, you know what? You know, you can take a step. You can take a, you know, you can, if you don't step, you fail. But if you do step,
you might win.
You might win. I mean,
you might win.
He said it so much better. And I wish
I wish we could have recorded that conversation, because that was a very awesome conversation from the guy Honor that we met that day. And he definitely, it definitely was something I needed to hear at the moment, because, you know, when you're going through a little something at the moment, you know, we all human, we go through our things.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And in sumo world, it's always a trick up the sleeve. It's always something that's going on, all right?
Yeah.
But when you're going through it, you definitely want to figure out a way to swim your way through it and get back to land.
The thing is that when you're trying to reach a certain level of success, a lot of times, especially if you got a long way to go, the best way to go there is to do it one step at a time. Let's literally realize what your goals are. Find out what it takes to get there.
Yep.
And then literally one step at a time,
complete
objectives.
I have to read this quote.
Go ahead.
My boy June Manning, man, you know what I'm saying? One of the brothers of life right there.
Okay.
He said that winners never quit and quitters never win.
Man.
Born to win.
Don't quit.
Born to win.
The way you don't quit is by being around positive people that encourage you. And if you have nobody positive to encourage you, listen to the show. Listen to Sumo. Listen to Sumo. Sumo will encourage you.
Definitely, man. That's what we're here for.
I'll encourage you.
We are here for the betterment. You know what I'm saying? The betterment of life. I'm trying to make sure that all the people that I get in contact with in life, that I can touch you. Not saying I got the power of Christ or something like that, but I do believe that I breathe life into people.
You speak with your intention. Your intention is for H-Town to succeed.
Hey, on
everybody,
top.
Everybody eats.
Y'all see this shirt I got on right now?
What you got on
this
there?
This is how you support your friends.
Tell them about it.
Listen, this shirt I have on is from the film, the new Hurricane Harvey movie, right?
Oh, wow.
Which let me move my chain over so you can see. So see that says, Michael Sterling film.
Okay.
All right? It's called Harvey. Michael Sterling has been my friend and been my homeboy before he ever touched a camera.
Tell me about Michael Sterling.
Michael Sterling is actually one of the greatest minds and filmmakers that I've ever met in my life, because, in fact, I got to watch his transition.
Wow.
And see the shirt I'm wearing? I bought this shirt.
It wasn't given to you for free?
Why did I buy this shirt? Because I wanted to support what he's doing. He has a Hurricane Harvey movie, and he's funding it himself.
Pay attention.
So he wanted to start selling merchandise so that he can pay for the movie without having to ask anybody for donations or figure out another way. So he pressed up shirts, and he hit all his friends and said, "Hey, man, I'm selling these shirts for $25. I'm in the middle of the movie. I'm trying to get all the way through it." And guess what? With no hesitation, as he called it, I swiped the card.
So you paid, you put money up.
Yes.
So it wasn't given to you.
No.
So people that ask you for free stuff.
Sumo, baby. Sumo, you got to know my name. You know what I'm saying?
So the thing is, ladies and gentlemen, it sounds like in order to be the boss, you must pay the cost.
You got
to
pay the bill, man. This man has really hit me with some good knowledge. June said, if we don't inspire and motivate or support one another, we have no business of being in contact. And that is something that I also preach about being a grown man. When I see groups of dudes that hang out together, right,
mm-hmm.
and they not building anything together, I'm like, what are you together for?
Wow.
Why are you riding the same cars? Why are you smoking all this weed together? Why are you doing any of this drinking? Why are you doing anything that you're doing if it's not building something together?
Why?
Because at the end of the day, guess what? A couple of facts that we know about life.
Go ahead.
You're going to get older.
Yeah.
Rent is due on the first.
You right.
Your light bill due on the first.
Man.
Your kids going to need whatever they're going to need every single day of their life.
Right.
So if you hanging out and you not building, then you are disrespecting your family, mm-hmm. disrespecting yourself, you disrespecting God and what he put inside you, and you got to get better, man.
I feel you.
I love some Thug and them Get Better game.
That's one of the law of thermodynamics right there. Without any outside influence, things over time will start to become more chaotic. It's called the law of entropy.
It's very true. I saw Zero, right? And, you know, last time I saw Zero,
yeah,
he was a little chunkier.
Okay.
And I've seen him now. He slimmed down.
Yeah.
Got his physique on. Walk around, you know, with his chest up.
Okay.
And I was like, look at this dude. He's a little young bodybuilding guy. You know? Hey, where you get that from? Did you buy that with all that money you're making now?
Shout out to Zero. Zero, if you're listening, if you hear us, we support you, and we appreciate the fact that you are focused on self-improvement.
Yeah.
And we recognize that.
Real deal. And I'm going to tell you, when I saw him, it was like, I told him, you know, I'm trying to get like y'all. That's my aim in life, is to get my health under because the wealth without the health is a dead end road.
Man.
It's dead end. If you're trying to, you got to motivate and keep it going in all aspects, man.
Health is wealth.
Yeah, you got to keep it going. Like my boy, what y'all call him? My boy, BHO Rico, man. He told me, he was like, man, let's make a deal. You lose another 100 pounds, he going to customize me a Boss Life unit.
Oh, wait. Will you get... Bro,
Customize the shirt, customize the pants, and I get the Boss Life shoes.
So, I want some Boss Life.
But you ain't fat enough. You ain't got no weight to lose. You got to go... You going to just go buy your stuff, man.
Look, if
you... Cali Boy Vega, what's up, baby?
Slim Thug, Strict grind. If you're out there, man, I want some Boss Life t-shirts, bro. And I will market whatever I got to do. I would like some Boss Life.
That boy said that real calmly. I would like some Boss Life t-shirt from Thug. Hey. But no, listen. My boy Steve-O say he wants some Boss Life. That's cool, man. But I know as for me, I want to earn it because I want to lose his weight. And then I'm going to take some of y'all girlfriends. I'm going to walk up to them in the club and do that dance.
Ooh.
I'm going to do that dance.
Who don't do it?
Hold on. Now, they ain't how them young dudes do the dance. Maybe.
Oh, you know, with the two-step? Or you know.
Man, you know, hey, man, I ain't going to lie. I think my boy got that busting out your body right now. He got that bus going. I can do that. That boy got that bus. That OTB fast lane, man.
Push it.
Big homie, Strict Grind, stay tuned in. Man, I appreciate the love, too, man, because that's from the streets to the beach, you know what I'm talking about? Y'all don't know nothing about that, though. If y'all ain't seen OTB Fast Lane do that bus, you need to go to the OTB Fast Lane show, man. He is guaranteed to make you have to stand up. Even if you can't dance, I was in the background yesterday at the show, and as soon as that, where's your dog at? Where's your dog at? I got money on me. I may be just mad.
What?
Get on this bus.
What?
Need your bus pass.
What?
Yeah, I was like, hey, man, we were getting it in, man. That boy had me on that. Y'all know I don't do no dancing, but I just was feeling that boy, your dog ass.
Well.
And I'm just kicking that leg. You know, big boy will kick one leg up when he dances. Flack one leg, flack the other leg. Hey. But, hey, that just lets you know that Houston hip-hop is coming back when, because, you know, the original first dance in Houston was what? Y'all know what it was, man. As soon as it come on, South Side. Yeah. So Kiki had her doing the South Side, right?
Right, right.
And then
right.
The young dude, AJ and Keanu, hooker. But nah, now we play up with it. What's your dog ass? So hey. I'm with that. And then that dog ass is actually a good exercise. Well, I can, you know, I can lose a little weight while I'm doing that.
See?
So, you know, shout out to OTB Fast Lane, that whole team out there. Don't miss the bus. My boy going worldwide. And he's on a double XL cover for a freshman this year. If y'all don't know, so y'all need to get on his Instagram, get on his Facebook, and give a lovely shout out to OTB Fast Lane, because that boy is working his ass off on behalf of OSC and the whole team, man, in Afghanistan, man. So it is what it is, man.
Shout out to him.
You got to get a love where it's at, man. Strict Grind, man. I see Wi-Fi out there working too, man. Yeah. That boy Steve was hitting y'all with that voice.
Strict Grind with OTB in the building.
If y'all don't get Steve-O on some albums talking for y'all intros, man, I'm telling you, you're losing right now, man. You're losing.
Hey, it's Young Bill Rap Sumo. the legend the building.
Hold up. So listen, this is what I need from y'all, man. SumoWorldBookings@gmail.com. Send me some music. I'm gonna play a couple of songs. I'm gonna pick through them. You know what I'm saying? Play a couple of songs. Tomorrow I got two special guests coming in the building. You know what I'm saying? I got my boy Shooter the Outlaw.
What?
And then we got a Texas legend, more than likely. I ain't gonna tell y'all who just yet.
Uh-oh.
But you know, he's a high ranking soldier, baby.
Uh-oh.
And he gonna come in the building with him tomorrow, man. So y'all get ready for it, cause it's always going down when I'm in town. It's always. Y'all know y'all be looking like Big Boy be doing that pimp step. That's cause I be hanging out with Ski Todd, man.
Oh man.
You know, I hang out with Ski Todd, so I gotta, you know what I'm saying? And then one time. There you go.
Yeah.
I won't lie to you, man. I want to give a shout out to my brother Justin, man. My little brother, he got shot Friday night in his hand.
Damn,
by man. I can't speak and say the kind of words I want to say, but I'm gonna say this. All you dudes out there who think it's cool to go try to rob people and just, you know, shoot random folks and all that kind of stuff, man, y'all need to grow up, man. And y'all better know that what goes around comes around, man. You cannot become successful doing unsuccessful things, man. All right? It's not going to happen. I can't say the kind of stuff I want to say, but I'm just going to say that, hey, man, I got a lot of love for a lot of people, man. I pray for all y'all every night, and I believe that the violence needs to stop because it's senseless.
Yeah.
There is not enough money that can make you maneuver like that. You know what I'm saying? And I know y'all think money is everything, but guess what? When you get shot and you laying there in the hospital, I promise you, money's not on your mind.
Well.
So while you out there doing that and you feel like the money's going to save you and it's going to put you where you need to be, money will never be the thing on your mind when you're in a situation where your life is almost taken.
Ooh.
So when you take a life, believe me, God got funny ways of making things come back around. All right? And money's not going to be the thing that's going to be on your mind, man. I just want to let y'all know that, man. So please refrain from the violence, man. You got a problem with somebody, try to talk it out. You ain't got to pull the trigger, man. Live your life and be happy. I'm here for this, man. I'm here to be happy. Man, happy belated birthday to Devin the Dude, man. We over here jamming right now. Yeah. So, Steve-O, man.
What's good, Chick? What's good, Sumo? How you feeling, man?
So what financial advice can you give these artists? Like, what kind of new things are out that they can try to make money from when they can't, when they feel like the job not working, they hustle not working? What do you tell me about the Bitcoins and all that kind of stuff?
I'll tell you something, man. I mean, there are many different things that you can do. The first thing is have a goal.
Have a goal.
If you don't have a goal, then everything's just going to be kind of this cloudy idea in your mind that you just want to get to the next level.
Yeah.
But first things first, have the goal. If there's something that you need to accomplish in life that costs an amount of money that you don't have, the first thing is find out, have a goal to reach that dollar amount, whether it's $100, whether it's $1,000,
yeah,
whether it's $10,000 or $1,000,000. The thing is first have that goal of what you want to reach.
And stop being so scary.
Stop being, because scared money don't make
money. Scared money don't make no money. If you think I'm playing, I'm going to look at you funny. Scared money don't make no money. Scared money don't make no money. That means you got to take that little change you got put up, that just like you save it up for them new J's, you can stand that long, hot, funky line.
Right.
You need to go stand that hot, funky line to put your money in the bank.
Right.
And save it up and then do something with it.
The thing is you, once you have an idea of how much money you want to have to save up to do what you need to do, then after you make that decision and say, oh, let's say it's $10,000. Let's say a large amount of money, $10,000. That's your goal. Then you realize and set your life up that everything that you do either adds to you getting to that $10,000 or takes away from it. When you walk into the mall, you out there with your girl and she's like, oh man, you should get that. You should get that leather jacket, or you should get them fresh pair of J's that are going to cost you $400.
Then you look at it and say, no, your mama should get it. Tell her, no, your mammy should get that jacket.
Understand.
I want to save my money. So you go ahead and take the jacket to your mammy and let her buy it for you. I'm trying to save my bread so that I can come up and have things in life later on. You know what I'm saying? I had a talk with my partner June one day. He was telling me he still had the same car that I used to admire back when I was like 19 and 20 years old. Right? I still got that car. I'm like, man, that is a brilliant testimonial type thing. If you got a slab from almost 20 years ago.
And you still got it right now. So he has no car note?
Of course not.
Oh, okay.
Paid for by the following is what we like to say, man.
My man, when it comes down to it, you need to look at what you're spending and what you're making.
Yeah.
And the first thing that you can do is cut back on spending.
Cut back.
And that's going to help you get to that goal. I mean, like I said.
All you fast food people, man, stop spending y'all money, man. Go buy some groceries. Go home and cook you a meal. It ain't going to hurt you, man. Quit being lazy.
I'm just saying, if you want to reach a goal that you think is far away, you better get started.
Look, man, we got 5 minutes, man. Listen, we got 5 minutes, right? So on behalf of myself, I'm going to take some advantage since y'all ain't seen me no music to play. And I'm about to play my new single, our new single, you know what I'm saying? Hood Bosses and Young Bill Rap Sumo, Hogging for the North. Please tune in right now to Synergy's live feed. I want everybody to go to my page on Facebook and tune into the live feed so y'all can hear this song, man. You know what I'm saying? I want y'all to vibe with me on this one, all right? I want y'all to feel it for real that, yeah. I got it. I'm finna run it right now, all right? I'm trying to see, should I run it on the Facebook or run it on the Instagram? Which one should I run it on, baby? Any, mini money. I only got 5 minutes to go. Y'all know my name. My name is Sumo.
Well,
go to church.
Well,
get some grips.
Okay,
tell her no.
Oh,
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 oh.
On Vogues,
say they love me, man.
On Foles,
on Foles. That boy say I'm gonna send you some. What's the email? Man, it's 5 minutes, brother. Hold on, brother. You're gonna have to hold on. But say he gonna send me. See this young cat who's on here right now. I ain't gonna lie to you. He kind of don't understand the basis of how we doing this. Hey. So what we're going to do right now is run this Hogging for the North, right?
Okay.
And I want y'all
Hogging
to
for the North.
Tell the truth about how y'all feel about the record, which I know the record is hot. So, you know, I do care about what y'all think, though. So let's go. We're going to run it right now.
Run it. Let's do it.
Turn it up, brother.
You got
Sumo
it.
Sumo World. Lord of the North.
Sumo World, Lord of the North.
Let's go. Money screaming, fuck your record deal. Yeah. H-Town boy, that's how we feel. Yeah. Okay. Double cup, nigga, no spill. Yeah. Say they gripping on that wood wheel. Yeah. Yeah. Bitch, I'm hungry for the North. I'm hungry for the North. Bitch, nigga, I'm hungry for the North. I'm hungry for the North. Yeah, nigga, I'm hungry for the North. I'm hungry for the North. Bitch, nigga, I'm hungry for the North. I'm hungry for the North. I'm getting money, screaming, fuck your record deal. Yeah, H time, boy, that's how we feel. Yeah, steady gripping on that wood wheel. Yeah, double cup, nigga, no spill. Yeah, bitch, I'm hungry for the North. I'm hungry for the North. Your record deal, yeah. H-Town, boy, that's how we feel, yeah. Steady gripping on the wheel, yeah. Double cup, nigga, no spill, yeah.
Before I'm hogging for the North. And ballin' on the South. Coming by 19 and slab. And I'm paying the cost to be the boss. The racks be on me when I floss. Fuck boy, I'm strapped with the Nino Ross. I'm blowing on gas in a glass house. And I'm about to piss these hoes out. We getting to the money
for certain.
Keeping that wheel wheel working. Claiming you got a record deal, but your pockets stay hurt. I came to rumble in the jungle, rippin' Lone Star State. Them out of towners still outside and pouring up what we drink. We scraping plates and candy paint. Man, it's the city of Sir. We getting Dinetto down in Texas. Jack, so fuck what you heard. You see these diamond dancing on me. We the lords of the North. You looking for your baby mama. I'ma be in her mind.
We getting money screaming. Fuck your record deal.
Yeah.
no spill. Yeah, bitch, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Yeah, bitch, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Yeah, nigga, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Yeah, nigga, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. You sex my home. Now side is my throne. I'm 44 acres home. No pleasure where I roam. Travel line like a marching band. Sitting straight for the land. Them double cups stay running though. We live a screw life. Money made when the flock sin. No hate when the block win. Hold it down when the air fin. This love is now, so don't pretend. Both flipping like a trampoline. Pushing weight straight gasoline. Oh, I love y'all. My bad, I let the song play. Oh, love, let's get it back.
Still in the streets like it concrete. Still riding slap like T.I.Z. Chuck the deuce to F.L.I.P.
Raise the face, didn't really make me.
Acres home, through the woods, fifth boy, city gas, homestead, Sundays, trillest moment I ever had.
Now side
about the cash, at where we go, we get a
we fame. Getting money, screaming, fuck your record deal. Yeah. Time, boy, that's how we feel. Yeah, steady gripping on the wood wheel. Yeah, double cup, nigga, no spill. Yeah, bitch, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Bitch, nigga, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Yeah, nigga, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Yeah, nigga, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no.
I've been hungry for the no. The underground on the bouts, 100 pounds in the vault. I make them bounce in the doubt. I get them on, get them off. On the phone, I don't talk. Get your zone and get lost. I'm Al Capone in the drought. Traffic in and out the house. Ooh, I got some shadows on the roof. I tell them to and they'll flip you. Full blooded red nose, pit bull and a blue
that'll grip you.
Fuck a record deal. We don't want a deal. Count $100,000 bill. Outside known as Cashville. Check a pussy like a
pass meal.
Street niggas running up a check. Hustle money like we buried in debt. Icicles all on my neck.
Avalanche running down my chest.
Outside we demand respect. Shoot down anything less.
Yeah.
We connected on the side. Plugged in with the
I'm getting money streaming. Fuck your record deal. Yeah. H time, boy, that's how we feel. Yeah. Steady gripping on them wood wheel. Yeah. Double cup, nigga, no spill. Yeah. Bitch, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no. Yeah, bitch, I'm hungry for the no. I'm hungry for the no.
Oh, love, man. Oh, love. Oh, love. We hogged for the North. We done it live today. We done gave everybody a little game. Y'all know what I'm saying? And it's real. And this is Sumo World Radio, man. Thank y'all for tuning in. Hope y'all tune in tomorrow. And I'll be here at 12:30 to 2 o'clock. A special guest coming in. Hey, man, I love y'all. In the memory of Wicked Cricket, show love, get love. Sumo World, and we got Sumo.